I've never met a wild thing that was left unscarred. I remember sitting on my grandfather's lap. He was all gasoline and ocean eyes and scratchy whiskers. He was highway madman, fixer of all things broken and scarred hands that held me strong but soft. I would trace each of the jagged pink crevices on his hands with the tip of my finger. My own skin was too fresh to know age. His was too sage to know whole. It was callow against callous. And with each trace of his mark, he would say proudly, logging accident, rusty boat hull, Mustang transmission. And now, I don't know how I got from there to here, but it's strange that I could once look at scars and see healing while all I now see is hurt, because human was once beautiful to me in all of its cracked perfection, but now I try to hide away my scars. I try to hide away exactly what makes me human. God forbid I show that I am human. Why do I hate myself for being human? I say this word so many times over, I don't really know what it means anymore. But I do know that the only live things that I ever met that were left unscarred were those kept in cages, and I don't want to be tamed. I don't want to walk this earth afraid, wear warning signs and say, caution, human creature, 60% water, 40% organic elements, please handle gently, don't handle me gently. We would never ask the moon to be crater-free or the ocean floor to be even. We would never say to the mountains, why so jagged, or the roots of trees to straighten, because scarring is not evidence of weakness, but proof of our innate capabilities to overcome hurt. So I will take a lesson from the mountaintops and moon, bending and breaking myself into a better shape, and if I am truly made of water, I will let myself run freely, but don't handle me gently. Don't try to soften the sharp edges of this world, because I have never met a truly wild thing that was left unscarred, and I don't want to be tamed. I refuse to walk this earth afraid.